If you're involved in music ministry, or any ministry for that matter, you should be mentoring someone. Today on Friday 5 and 5, I'm sharing 5 tips for being a great mentor. One of the goals at our church is that anyone involved in any way at the Refuge is mentoring someone. I mean, what happens if you're called out on a missions trip, or have to take maternity leave? Or what if your ministry focus is shifting? Someone else should be able to step into your shoes and carry on seamlessly in your absence. And more than that, we should be investing in and raising up other leaders. I think this is especially important in music ministry. Worship leaders should be mentoring up-and-coming worship leaders. Musicians, vocalists, and ministry leaders should all be mentoring too. What we're doing in the kingdom of God is so much bigger than ourselves. We have a responsibility to pass on what we've learned and sow into the success of others. So let's start with tip number 1 for being a great mentor. Have a plan. Sometimes we bounce onto ideas that sound great, but we don't put a lot of thought into them. If you're going to be a great mentor, don't wing it. It's so much harder to stick with the mentorship and be consistent if you don't have a plan. You and your mentoree should talk about expectations and set some goals for the mentorship. Tip number 2 is show genuine interest. Being a mentor is not something to take lightly. If it's something you want to do just so you can say, "Hey, I'm a mentor," then don't. A great mentor is invested in the success of their mentee, and they get to know the person for who they are. Find out what interests them, what scares them, what areas are they wanting to grow in. Find out why they're so passionate about music ministry, or whatever ministry it is. Spend quality time with your mentee. Being a mentor isn't about you doing all the talking, but it's also about listening with intention. And a little bonus piece of advice: your relationship should always come before the mentorship, especially when you're working in the church. Tip number 3 is share what you know. Don't have the mindset that you need to withhold information in order to protect your position. God doesn't work that way. There's plenty of room in His kingdom, and you will always have a place in it. So leave that mindset behind and be generous with your knowledge, tips, and resources. If you want to read more about having an abundance mentality, you can check out the blog post link in the description below. And I'll tag onto this tip that it's also important to let your mentee learn from your mistakes. Don't paint a perfect picture of yourself. Share your mistakes and what they taught you. It's best to be honest and transparent in a mentorship. Tip number 4 is practice what you preach. It's easy to tell someone what to do, and we all know what we should be doing, but it's important to be an example and let your actions back up what you say. Show your mentee how your relationship with God is essential when it comes to leading others into worship. Show her what it looks like to be prepared and bring something of excellence. Show him what it looks like to be respectful of the others on your team and keep a great attitude. As a mentor, make sure you practice what you preach. And number 5 is celebrate. It's important to motivate your mentee and boost their confidence. Celebrating their successes, both big and small, is a great way to do this. Mentorships can often remind someone how much there is to learn or how much they have to grow. Remind your mentee that it's about taking one step at a time, and every little achievement counts. Be quick to celebrate those achievements with your mentee. If you're in a leadership or ministry role, you should be investing in someone else. I hope these 5 tips for being a great mentor help you out. If you enjoyed this video, then give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel.